Okay, we had more on this issue. We had the dance teacher from Central, and we had a person that I did ask, did invite out here, Rashad Turner, and he made some comments at the last night school board meeting that in terms of the number of black students that are suspended, the violence, the talked about substitute teachers, and he also made the comment that the achievement gap is attributable to the retired teachers because they created it. So we'll let him, if he shows up next week, we'll let him speak. We have his comments, we have the dance teacher's comments, but we don't have time. I said we had enough for a 3-hour show tonight. We want to get, there is one more short clip that you guys played earlier, and this is Jennifer and Donovan,
mm-hmm.
And thank you for hanging over that. Your issue is the, like all these school districts, whether it's St. Paul, Matamidi, Stillwater, what the system, what the school board is doing to the parents and the students. So we had a little bit of this conversation last week. What would you like to share in terms of what's going on in Stillwater, maybe with the demographics of the population? The Met Council is pushing the population into Lake Elmo, more high density. They're putting in more sewer lines out there. It seems to me like they want to close the schools in the north part of the Stillwater District and move it to the southern part, reconstitute or reformulate. I would like that piece played, but let's hear from you two. Where do you want to jump into this conversation?
Well, it's interesting what you say about the Met Council and the population growth and all the building that's happening in Lake Elmo. One of the things that sticks out for me with this bold proposal, which is building opportunities for learning and discovery, it's basically a proposal to close 3 schools in the Stillwater School District. There are 2 northern schools, Withrow Marine, and then there's a 3rd that's in South Hill, Stillwater, which is Oak Park.
And they call this an opportunity for what?
Learning and discovery.
Can somebody explain that to me, how closing schools is an opportunity for learning and discovery?
Well, it's interesting what you said about this, the building that's going on in the Lake Elmo area. So last year we passed a bond referendum to about $90 million.
And
that will be used to build a new school in that area. If you dig a little deeper on that, you'll find that really, and the administration hasn't hid this, that the reason that has come up to build that new school is not simply because of the population growth. It's because they lost a school called Valley Crossing. So Valley Crossing was a joint effort between Woodbury, Stillwater, I think North St. Paul, and we, South Washington County, Stillwater, all made bids on this building to take control of it so that they could house their students there. We, Stillwater School District, made a bid, didn't bid high enough, lost, and it was awarded to South Washington County. And now, because we're losing that building, those kids that were in Valley Crossing, is about 300 students, don't have anywhere to go. And that's what's stemming, where that a large chunk of that referendum money is going to be
targeted
for.
So it was a joint agreement that the building was shared between the 3 school districts,
mm-hmm.
and those students were allowed to go to that school because that geographically it was closer to all those students.
To help take the stress
off
the surrounding areas.
So now that South Washington, Woodbury, decided, mm-hmm. okay, we'll buy it just for our students. We have enough students. It's forcing the Stillwater District to build their mm-hmm. own school.
Mm-hmm. Well,
towards that end of the school district. And so in doing that, they're saying, okay, now we're going to close these 3 schools up on the northern or north central part of the school district.
Yep.
And those three schools, talk about academically how those three schools are.
Well, why don't you talk about your schools? I'll talk about.
Sure. Well, so my son attends Marine. He's a kindergartner. Marine is it's a blue ribbon school, nationally ranked school. Withrow is another one in the north, is also a nationally ranked school for test scores and education. They have a, in the north, it's more rural communities, obviously, and they have a smaller enrollment and a smaller school model. So the nice thing with the district as it stands today is that you have choice. You can go to a small school like that in the north. There's alternate enrollment available, so you have a choice of what school would be the best fit. With these closing, then the choices, you know, would be limited. But they are, I guess, academically very high-performing schools.
Mm-hmm. And Oak Park is, I think, ranked number 4 in the district, so it's not a
sure.
poor-performing school. But we also are home to the ASD program. It's the autism program. So we have 18 students in our school with a special sensory room. But those students are also integrated into the classrooms as
part
well.
Part of the day.
Part of the day. Yeah. And then we also are home to the GATE program, the Gifted and Talented Education Group, which is fourth through sixth grade. And then as well as having the other K through six classes.
So that would go away. Those schools would physically be closed.
Mm-hmm.
And the other issue is that, and that the part of the reasoning for merging the district by a group of parents, there's 1,600, I understand, people that are in the group that you're here representing tonight, and that this group that was part of that want to have a petition to put on the ballot the merging of those districts, because those schools are close to the Matamidi district, and it would make sense to be able to share that and then mm-hmm. share the new high school over in there and the new elementary school over there, rather than these districts all building these multi-million dollar school buildings, closing some, building new ones. It made absolutely no sense. Let's take a call from one of the viewers. Caller, are you with us? Question or comment?
Bob Zick.
Make it short.
Did these guests realize that they're in the presence there of the most well-informed freedom fighter, Bob Zick? I recall 30 years ago, you became an expert on school districts when you saved the North St. Paul High School, when they wanted to close schools in North St. Paul. And you've been doing that for 30 years. Are you going to give these people some tips? Thank you.
We'll take any tips.
We'll take them.
Well, we did stop in the North St. Paul School District. They wanted to close Tartan and North and build one mega school. And one of their places that they had picked out was the Goodrich Golf Course, because of all things, the school district had, I guess we call it, eminent domain over a county golf course. And the superintendent, when I confronted him why they were doing this, he said, well, because it will give us a better stature in terms of athletics and debate and all the different competitions, because we'll have this larger student body to pick from.
Sure.
And I reminded him, and you're only going to allow half as many students the opportunity to participate. So we've been fighting this kind of nonsense. Mm-hmm. For years. Do we have that one clip ready to play that I wanted? That from the previous show about reconstituting? We had what was that, one of the school board members? I told her we wanted to play that. Well, when you work with volunteers, apparently our pay scale isn't high enough. Oh, wait, they're volunteers.
Well, first I want to say thank you. I actually graduated from Tartan. So
did you?
Thanks for not closing my school.
Two daughters graduated from there. So obviously you're about the same age, so I won't put you on the spot and ask you what year. All right, so what are some of the other points? I heard, was somebody from the Stillwater School District, the school board, say they're not closing the schools, they're going to reconstitute this? St. Paul did this when they closed schools. They used the word, it sounded like orange juice, you know, reconstituted. Mm-hmm. It's not fresh, it's... We yeah. squeezed it, now you can reconstitute it.
Well, I think the main message that he was giving, it was Dennis Bloom, he was saying that, you know, our intent isn't to close the school, and he made the suggestion that maybe we put some of the central services staffing in the schools. So that was kind of his last point, but he clearly said our intent is not to close any schools.
So does that mean the students will still go there, or they'll close it as a school and use it for administration?
Well, that is now their intent with Oak Park Elementary, is they will close it for students and move the central services offices in there. And that's coming on the tails after we passed the bond that they're going to be putting air conditioning into the school. And we just, the PTA just donated $3,000 2 years ago to upgrade the computer lab for it. I mean, so it's just, you know, you put money and you vote for things for the school, but you do that for the children. You don't do that for the central services.
So you, and that whole referendum was contentious out there anyway, because in the previous ones were turned down by the voters. So now they sold the voters this bill of goods of what they were going to get, and now they're going to get something different. Mm-hmm. Is that a fair statement?
I think so, yeah. I mean, with the what we voted on was, I think those things are still going to happen, but the outcome, the unintended consequences, I will say, mm-hmm. that they didn't tell us, which was maybe they talk about wanting to close schools for 20 years. That's what they're saying, that it's been in their plan. But as you talk about some of the backroom conversations, those conversations weren't out to the public at all. And so I don't think people would have voted for this knowing that three schools were going to be closing.
And that's the whole issue. So because we're winding down here, how does viewers in the Stillwater area, because this show plays through Valley Access out there, how do they get hold of, you know, somebody that's part of the 1600 that want to protect their schools and what's...
Yeah, well, I think the first thing to do is to visit stopboldcold.org and visit the website.
And that's, do that again?
Stop Bold Cold.
Stop, STOP.
Bold, BOLD.
BOLD.
Cold.
COLD.
.org.
.org. Yeah. Well, that's a good name. Stop Bold Cold.
Mm-hmm. Well, and so there are a ton of parents who have done a significant amount of research. There's a lot of data out there to support our reasoning of why closing schools is not a good idea and why it does not help districts. There's a lot of reverse consequences that happen when you consolidate schools. And so I think you can find a lot of information out there that supports our cause. If I can just say, going forward, what we're hoping that the board will do is give us more time and delay the vote. Allow us to work together and collaborate so we can come together to come up with more solutions.